bok choy, when you add it in there, since bok choy, it does a lot of liquid, like a lot of juice that comes out of it. So that juice will leak in the dumpling, like that dumpling pocket. And it's so good. It's juicier. It's like a juicier dumpling.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Marilla's Food. So today what we're going to be doing again is just the usual. We're going to cook and we're going to eat.
Who's ready?
Who's ready? Yeah. So here I have my friend.
Do you guys remember me?
From our carbonara video.
Yep.
Yeah, so pretty much this episode is going to be very healthy. As we both have a lot of events to go to. So
our diet?
Diet, yeah. We just want to eat cleaner. That was our New Year resolution. Just to eat cleaner, like less out, less takeaway, less fried food.
Even though it's February, it's starting now.
It's starting now, yeah. So what's on the menu today is we're going to cook some kale chips. They're really good. It's really simple, really easy. We're gonna show you how to do that. It literally takes like 3 minutes prep max. And then we're gonna make rice paper rolls. Have you ever had that before?
Yeah, Marie made it for me once.
Okay, yeah. So we're gonna have rice paper rolls and we're gonna make dumplings as well. So it'll be dumplings, rice paper rolls, and
kale chips.
Yeah. So we're just gonna healthify everything. So it's not gonna be like the traditional way. Cut everything. We'll just pass.
Yeah.
So probably what we're gonna do is gonna prep everything for our three dishes. Pooja is gonna get started on just like we're gonna do everything to long strips just for our rice paper rolls.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So just kind of like just like strips like that size.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can cut that.
Got it.
Okay, so with these kale chips, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take the stems off all of these and then I'll wash it in a second. Yeah, that was good. I'll get you a plate in a second. So for our rice paper rolls, what we're going to be using, the noodles that we're going to use is this. I pretty much grew up eating these noodles. It's rice vermicelli.
Chicken.
I'll show you guys my chicken. It's boiling away. So that's my chicken. That's my noodles. And here I'll show you my kale. We're only going to have these two veggies for our rice paper rolls, and I have some fresh herbs and mints, and we're gonna wrap it with vermicelli noodles and protein, which is chicken thigh today. I'm gonna dip some hoisin sauce. You don't want two big pieces, so we'll just break them up as well.
Name out there.
Yeah. So pretty much all I've done with these is just pretty much lightly salted them. Lightly salted and peppered them to give them that flavour, and I just put a little bit of oil in here. And now we're just gonna put it in the oven to let it to let it crisp up.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. So we wanna finely chop everything. So with this bok choy, when you add it in there, since bok choy, there's a lot of liquid, like a lot of juice that comes out of it. So that juice will leak in the dumpling, like that dumpling pocket. And it's so good. It's juicier. It's like a juicier dumpling. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I have ginger. I'll show you a trick to peel the skin. Everyone probably knows it. Pretty much what you do is just use a spoon, you scrape the skin. Yeah.
You know that? You didn't know that.
I didn't know. Okay. This is our dumpling bowl. I'll come up closer and I'll tell you what we have in it. So pretty much what we have is silken tofu, green onions, bok choy, regular onion, and then we have ginger. We're supposed to have garlic in here, but I just don't have any garlic. Okay, we're going to put our mince in and then we're going to season it. I'm gonna quickly marinate these dumplings. I'll show you what I usually put in. So I'll put some fish sauce in. A little bit of soy sauce.
Are people in Asia very crazy over Maggi?
A little bit of soy sauce. Chises.
She said just a little bit, guys, but ended up being.
Oh. I won't put any salt in. I won't put any salt in.
12 minutes of salt. Is that sugar?
Sugar. Yeah, this is brown sugar. Just a bit of brown sugar. You don't have to use brown sugar, but that's all I have at home. Sugar.
Well, I never use sugar in dumplings.
Yeah, to balance out the saltiness. Because you know how, like, ours will be too salty.
Mm.
And then I'm going to put some chili flakes in just a bit. And lastly, black pepper. Oh, this one's going to take forever. Actually, I'm going to put some chicken stock in, actually. Just a bit. Just a bit of chicken stock.
Oh, you reckon the dumplings have to take forever to make?
Oh, they take pretty fast. Mm. We're going to have to make it look pretty.
Yeah.
I don't have to. I mean, like the...
Mmm. Well done.
We already tried it.
I'm going to have it. That's the seasoning, guys. It's good, so
yeah. I'm just going to mix this.
And if you're craving chips, this is like such a perfect alternative. Because it even tastes like kale. Like it tastes like kind of like nothing, but like it still has the flavor of a chip in it.
Is it good?
It's so good. Oh my god, guys! Yeah, it smells really good. It
smells like flavorful.
Yeah, it smells like season. Couple goals.
That's good.
So good.
Good, yeah.
It tastes like
that's good.
It tastes like those like thin chips that you get, like the original thin chips, the blue packet. It tastes like that, guys. What does kale taste like to you? Can you hear that crunch? You should crunch it really loud. Here, I'll do it.
Yeah, you do it.
Okay, guys, I'm gonna crunch it really loud.
So I just went to Coles. Usually I'll buy the dumpling wrappers. They're like the white round ones. But we went to Coles, they didn't have any. The only ones they had was the wonton wrapper, so we're just gonna opt for this. So this is what it looks like. It's like cheese. So pretty much what we wanna do. We need about like that much. And then just put it in the middle. Really, it doesn't really matter what shape you can do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like that.
Mm-hmm.
And you wanna hold it in your palm like that. And then you wanna pinch it. So I'll show you.
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you pinch it.
I think I did this when I was waitressing at the...
Did you? Oh, maybe mine has too much filling. Pretty much, you get a dumpling like this.
I think mine's gonna look really dodge. I don't know how to do this.
Oh, I'll show you an easier option. You don't have to do like that. You can just do like... You can just fold it. You can just do like this. I'll show you. Oh, and just pinch it.
Oh, right.
Just pinch it. Yeah, like that. Okay, so all you can do it like this. And we learned that like, so when you cook it, what we're gonna do is we're gonna like half, it's like shell, not shallow fry, it's like pan fry and half steam, like a gyoza. So it's pretty healthy still. But we learned that this one, like this shape, is better than this shape because you get maximum crunchiness. So when you fry it, we fry it like that.
Mm.
And you get like this whole bit of crunchy, whereas if you fry this, you only get this bit of crunchiness. I don't know if that makes sense. Okay guys, we're back. We have everything prepped. We have our dumplings ready to go. We have all our rice pepper roll ingredients. Come closer.
Okay.
We're just a bit hangry at the moment.
I'm
had
so
food all morning.
I know, guys, and it's 3 o'clock in the
it's
afternoon.
It's 3 p.m. and we literally spent the whole day prepping for this. Okay, so I just have some oil in here.
Mine is a little
cook away, babies. Cook away.
This is a new DJ remix by Maria.
What?
Cook away.
Just fry entire bottom bit to get that crispiness going on. Oh my god, they're burning. Okay, so once they're crispy, like this, oh my god, it's burning. I can smell it.
Oh. Wait, do you want to help me?
You're gonna pour water in it and close the lid. So we're just gonna make our rice paper rolls all the way. I'm so hungry, so we're gonna eat.
Yeah, me too, guys. Starved. Can we put the bowl in the middle?
Yep.
Such good flavor combinations, guys. It's so healthy.
So good?
Mm-hmm. Doesn't even taste like we're on a diet.
Mm. Like, nothing here is really fried. Nothing here is fried. Yeah. I'll sriracha sauce if you want.
Thanks, mate.
Good?
Mm-hmm. Look how good that looks, guys. Do you want avocado taste good in this?
Mmm. I'll never try that. I'm sure it tastes good.
Mmm. Good?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If you guys have ever been to Rolled and they sell those rice paper rolls, this is better. Mm. It's so much cheaper.
Mm. So good.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like the bit of movement?
Yeah, the taste really good. It's very refreshing and the
good, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if we try the dumplings next, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've got a bit of sauce for it.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I'm gonna try sriracha on it.
Mm. So good!
Mm-hmm.
God, go into my white. Look at those juicy dumplings. Okay, we'll do a taste test right now.
Yep.
Okay. I'll try one that I made. So they should have a crispy bottom.
Will it be very hot?
Yeah, a little. Let's try it on. Did it get closer to the camera? Let's get it. Oh, I'll do it. I'll do it for
them. Okay.
I don't know how to show it. Dunk it in that oil and let that fall.
Guys, this tastes so, so good.
Wow.
Oh my god.
How good is that?
Good?
Try it.
Okay.
Guys, look at that. This is so good. Are you struggling? So it's a bit dull.
Guys, I struggled with that. I think there was tears down my face. That was so hot.
Oh my god, this tastes so good.
Guys, that tastes so amazing. I can't even.
I love it.
Too hot?
Yeah. So like,
is it heat off?
Yeah. So like there's juice. So remember how we added bok choy in our dumplings? So that I told you before, that's like very like, it's very juicy. Like when you cook bok choy, there's a lot of liquid that comes out.
So good, guys.
Oh, shizes. So that liquid, that bok choy we put in, that will, what's it called? Juice. The juice of that. Oh my god. The juice of that.
Kind of comes out.
Yeah, it comes out in these little pockets, dumpling pockets. And it's so good. It's like soup dumpling. What's that? Mm. Oh my god, I keep dropping it.
So good, yeah. I'm gonna start making my own dumplings at home.
Good, yeah?
So good. Like,
so the last time I made carbonara is the first time making carbonara.
Yeah, and I kept making it.
And she kept making it.
Yeah. Guys, learn from Rory loves food. Feeling my pain? This should be like a hot challenge.
That's so good.
I can't get over it.
That's so good.
Guys, don't even bother to go eat out. Just make this recipe.
It's like so flavorful.
I love it.
It's so good, yeah? It's oh my god, I'm glad you like it. You like it?
I love it. It tastes better than, like, you know.
You know what? Yeah, wonton.
It tastes better than like all restaurants because it's like homemade fresh.
Homemade, you know what's going in it, no MSG, nothing.
Like home, like whenever you cook like stuff, it just tastes so much better.
So much better.
And you're, not even like, you don't have to spend that much money.
Do we roll it for you? I'm scared it'll dry out.
Oh no, I'll roll.
I'm just gonna have another dumpling.
That's so good.
That's so yummy.
So guys, Marie used to like do cooking?
Yeah, I used to cook. I used to go CIT and cook.
And this is where the passion has arrived. How good is it, Maria? Her face is telling me right now. My phone died, guys.
My phone has died. It's come back to life. Overheated, all sorts of things are happening right now.
It's pretty much an earthquake going on this house.
Oh wow.
Guys, I'm so sad. The dumplings are almost done.
I know. Here, put you one more left. One each left, yeah. Fuck, that was good.
Oh, I don't know. It's okay, guys. Swearing is part of natural life.
Okay, can you believe it? I used to not swear. Leading up to first year uni, I'd never said a swear word. Do you want some kombucha?
I don't know.
Have this. I'm not gonna drink it anymore.
You don't like kombucha?
Yeah, I do. I like it. It's alright.
Have it then.
I want it.
Really?
I have it. Okay. This is a very healthy way. I mean, healthy alternative to wash down food.
Exactly. Maria loves her Coke and.
I drink it as not too bad. I love it. But I need it if I'm eating like oily foods. Like oily foods. Food that are like this type of food is like hard to wash down. Like pasta, like fried chicken. You know how you like that oily taste? Yeah.
Guys, and do you know what we also started doing is reading.
I don't know. It's so weird. We're like changed. Yeah.
We're becoming more adulty.
Yeah. It's so weird because I hate reading. I absolutely hate reading. I remember we would have to like read, like we knew how to read like novels and that in like high school and college. My whole life, I only ever read two novels, which was The Day After Tomorrow and Hunger Games. The rest?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Wow. They were interesting, but we had to read it because, you know, getting assessed. But the others, I'll just look at Spark Notes and I'll just read stuff online. Like,
maybe some, Spark Notes?
Yeah, maybe everyone did that, but I just never enjoyed reading. But now I'm at that stage where I feel that reading is so crucial and so important.
Yeah, and it teaches you a lot.
It does. Like, It does something to you, and I just know that it does.
Good motivation speech.
Yeah. Hold on.
Okay. I thought this will increase my metabolism.
Well, that's probably pretty much it of our eating show today. I hope you guys learnt a little something, and that we kind of showed you that eating healthy and cooking at home, it's not too hard. There was a lot of prepping required, but at the end of this meal, it's worth it.
Yeah, exactly. It's so worth it.
And like, it just shows that like in the long run, if you were to keep up with this routine, imagine what you're doing for your body.
And imagine how much money you will save.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Thank you for watching.
Thanks, guys.
There'll be many more videos to come. And my goal this year, I'm going to try and do one video every 2 weeks. So yeah, get excited. Get excited.
You said that on video, so it's a promise now.
Yeah. Get excited. And tell me if you want me to cook, like recipes I should cook or meals I should cook.
Hmm.